my lungs. Gasping for air, I cried out for help as the weight of the drowning kayak tied to my waist pulled me down. I tried to look up towards the light, but all I could see was the clear blue sea, and my vision went blank. Fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, flashbacks of me drowning followed me like my shadow. That fateful incident had scarred me for life. One day, my manager, pleased with our work, decided to take us on an outing, which included scuba diving. Now, I had two options: embrace my fear and overcome it, say no and live in fear for the rest of my life. Now, the perks of us having adventurous friends is that they will push you to take that plunge into the unknown, with your leap of faith being the only available form of transportation, and hence, I decided to go for the outing. So the day came, and we were flying to a place that is famous for its white sand and blue waters, Andamans, for 3 days. So after that tiresome flight journey, we had a rather lazy first day, with the smokers smoking, drinkers drinking, and the teetotalers doing a God knows what. The next morning, we left for our scuba diving classes. Before I describe that, raise your hand if you have gone scuba diving before. Okay, great. So for those of you who don't know what it feels like, here goes. So we were taken to the shallow part of the sea and taught the basic actions, which are okay, not okay, up, down, and also how to equalize pressure and to breathe with the masks underwater. With that, our lessons came to an end. We were put onto a boat to be taken to the diving spot. As the boat rode each wave, my heartbeat was slowly pacing up. Flashbacks of me drowning flashed in front of my eyes like a screenplay. Suddenly, the motor turned off, and I could see my friends all lining up and given their oxygen masks. Watching each of them dive in, my palms started to sweat and my throat went dry. I sucked hard onto the nozzle, breathing in the compressed air. I closed my eyes, trying to reassure myself, it'll all be over soon. My scuba instructor noticed I was nervous. So he walked over towards me, held my head and said, "Son, I understand you were afraid, but what you see down there will make any fear look small. It's gonna be okay. Repeat after me, boy. It's gonna be okay." And with that, we dived into the hidden paradise. I tried to look up towards the light, and all I could see was the clear blue sea. We were slowly yet steadily going towards the seabed. Cold current brushed against my skin, sending chills down my spine. But what I saw left me astounded, astonished, and in awe of the beauty of God's creation. There were colorful corals of various shapes and sizes. Blue fishes with yellow gills, black fishes, big fishes, small fishes, clown fishes, all of them swimming around in patterns. Sea turtles with their eyes half closed, munching on algae. Seahorses perched on top of these corals like statues. Fishes with whiskers scouting for their prey. All of them not caring even the slightest bit about these new intruders in their environment. And suddenly, I was completely mesmerized. This serene and calm environment had left me completely mesmerized. I was caught in this net, cast by this aura of peace. And somehow, I did not want to break free. Part of me felt just at home. The only thing I probably needed was a trident and few mermaids to never go back up. But sadly, my oxygen levels were running low and I had to return. Coming back up to the surface, I could see that my fear had completely left me. I thanked my scuba instructor and made a note to myself saying, "I will come back again." Walking along the seashore on the third day, I could feel the warmth from the fine white sand. The breath of fresh, salty air bringing back memories from the dive. My eyes lit up as I swiped right, looking at the scuba diving pictures on my phone. This brings me to a famous Japanese proverb: fear is only as deep as your mind allows. You all have a lot of different fears: fear of public speaking, fear of the dark, fear of heights, and so on. Scuba diving was a means for me to get over my fear of the sea. Find yours, And no fear will seem too big. But if you're scared to start, always remember, it's gonna be emotional.